Shouldn't we shut the door behind us before we go?
That is true. Gotta have some manners. Oh, nah, he's got it. What's going on, everyone? Sweet Daddy Brown here, and today we are going to be playing Kingdom Hearts 3 Chain of Memories. It's basically a remake for the original Chain of Memories, which came out on the Game Boy Advance. And this one came out for the PlayStation 2. So it's basically 3D, like the Kingdom Hearts 1 and Kingdom Hearts 2, unlike the Game Boy version, which was, I think, top-down. But yeah, I'm going to be checking it out. This game, the events in this game take place directly after what happened in Kingdom Hearts, so that's why we're checking out this one next. And we'll see what happens. Oh, is it gonna be a repeat? I think it is, maybe. I'll just let this play out for you lads that haven't seen what happened in Kingdom Hearts 1 or just need a recap of what happened. There we go, that should freshen up your memories. And it seems they put the fight with the mysterious stranger, I already forgot his name. But they put it in the cutscene and it happened before. Oh, hello. Happened before we fought Xemnas or something. Oh wait, there's a guy named Xemnas, I don't even remember. Yeah, Xemnas? That's the same, that's the mysterious stranger. And Ansem was the big baddie of Kingdom Hearts 1. But yeah, this is what happened at the end of Kingdom Hearts 1. And now we're gonna be continuing off to search for King Mickey, it seems. I'm a Pluto. I think Pluto Bait it is. Where is this even? That's my question.
Along the road ahead lies something you need.
What's this? It's not Xemnas.
However, in order to claim it, you must lose something that is dear to you.
More voice actors.
Thank you.
That's a funky looking castle you got there, lads. Heart's Rechain of Memories. Visually, this was the better choice to go with than the Game Boy version. The original one, since it's all sprites, this actually has proper cutscenes like the PlayStation 2 Kingdom Hearts. Oh, no voices added though. Noise? What? No way, that's not Sora's voice. Samir, did they sound different? Oh wait, is this Sora Kingdom Hearts 2 Sora voice actor? I'm tripping. I don't even know, I gotta hear it.
Hey, you think it's okay to barge in?
But we gotta do it, if we're gonna find the king.
Okay, it's not normal now.
The king? King Mickey's here?
Something just told me he'd be here, okay?
Really? Cause now that you mention it, I was kinda thinking the same thing.
Maybe it was
seriously?
Pluto's letter?
Me too.
Holy shit.
One look at this castle, and I just knew.
Sir, after
our very best friends, they're here.
Yep. Guess great minds think alike.
Wait, hey, hold on.
Timmy.
It can't be just a coincidence.
Sora hit puberty, Timmy.
You don't mean that.
Yep, I had it too. I had the exact same feeling.
Gorge, maybe it's contagious.
No, something screwy. We gotta go take a look.
All right,
then.
Where are you going?
That way, to the door. Are you scared?
Don't be ridiculous. Come on, let's go, Goofy.
Hey, fellers, shouldn't we shut the door behind us before we go?
That is true. Gotta have some manners. Oh, nah, he's got it.
That's it. Who are you?
What? Hi, yes. Oh, yeah? I'll try some magic. Flutter!
That's, quality magic there, Donald.
Flutter! Flutter! Come on. Blizzard! Fire!
Earth, wind, fire.
Why isn't it working?
I should think it's obvious. The moment you set foot in this castle, you forgot every spell and every ability you ever knew.
That's convenient.
In this place, to find is to lose, and to lose is to find. That is the way in Castle Oblivion.
Castle Oblivion?
Here you will meet people that you have known in the past, and you will meet people you miss.
I miss? Riku! You mean Riku's here?
If what you want is to find him.
What'd you do?
I merely sampled your memories.
That's pretty.
And from them, I made this.
You what?
To reunite with those you hold dear.
What's this? A card?
It is a promise for the reunion you seek. Hold the car to open the door, and beyond it a new world. Proceed, Zora.
Alright, random ass dude in a hood.
To lose and claim anew. Or to claim anew, only to lose.
This guy's just talking in riddles, goddammit. Those are the worst types. Like the frickin' Riddler from Batman. Batman Forever, was it?
Come on. Let's go.
Jim Carrey's Dark Days. Dark Days in films. Card obtained, Traverse Stone. So in this game, you fight using cards. It's much different than the main titles. It's kind of like a side title. But it's important to know the events that occur here, because it basically ties left analog stick and press. Yes, okay, you only have one. Okay. Traverse Stone. But yeah, it's basically, it ties what happens between Kingdom Hearts 1 and 2. And also in this game, like the first one, X is for confirmed, not circle. So that's a relief. That's very bueno. I approve of that. This can't be right. We're in Traverse Town. What you see isn't real. This town is an illusion created by your memories ingrained in that card. My memories. Forget about that, Sora. We lost Donald and Goofy. Yeah, we did. That's unfortunate. Donald, Goofy, guys, where are you? Pay no heed to the shadow glitching out. What did you do with them? You're at the mercy of the cards now. That's nice. Master the cards and their strength will be yours again. Is this like a turn-based game? Oh crap, alright. Oh no. Loss of this castle require that your friends be transformed into cards. If you battle your friends, you won't fail to pick them up. Okay, left analog stick to move, right analog stick to move around. Yes, you can use the right analog stick to move around. Cards you pick up are added to the top of your stack. Use them and your friends will come to your aid. Okay. Use a card. Alright, Donald. That was kind of useless. Cards you use vanish, but they will reappear to aid you time and time again. Cards are the hearts of your friends. Everything in this castle is ruled by cards. Whether an enemy or a door confronts you, cards are the only way to proceed. But you mustn't forget your own strength. I can see why people don't like this game. Jump, dodge roll. Okay. First think for yourself, then move, then use the cards. It's because you use the cards and...
Yeah.
I use a card to attack? Whoa. Yeah, this is definitely the reason people don't like this game. Now I know how to use your strength, but it will be of no use if you lose the sight of your opponents. Wonder if you can catch me. Oh, my prologue. This is going to be in a prologue episode, by the way. R2 target release. Good. Every move you make causes a card to disappear. Why are you helping me? If you use up all your cards, you will be unable to that. There is a solution. Keep using cards until you run out, and I will show you. Alright. Oh, I can do a combo with these cards. Let's see. Why didn't they just... I don't know. You have no more cards, and without them, no power. If you want that power back, you must focus. Get the cards returned to you, and they will. Oh. Wait, reloading cards up quickly. Hold to reload cards. Alright, so I just hold. I don't even know what the fuck I was doing. Strength of your heart, brought back the lost cards. You can recall sent cards at any time. You only need to wish it, but each time you do, the cards will take longer to return. The cards are by no means unlimited, use them wisely. Anticipate the flow of battle. choose the most effective cards. You may choose any card in your deck. Okay. Yeah, I already did the damn it. The four card types you use in battle are grouped in two wider categories. First category includes attack cards, magic cards, and item cards. Second category consists entirely of enemy cards. To use cards from a different category, select button, change the categories. Whoa. Okay, I said a heartless. Cards will empower you whether you're attacking or defending. It is up to you to decide when to attack and when to defend. Do not forget that. Why is the volume in game louder than the like the videos? It's weird. Are you two alright? Where have you been? You tell us. When we opened the door, we saw a strange light. The race is just blank. I can't English. Gee, that doesn't help. I'm trying to remember what happened. I have to keep my journal up to date. Hey, Donald, where did I get the new clothes? What? Me too, Goofy. These are the clothes that were in Kingdom Hearts 2, I guess. Somebody's been messing with our clothes. Could it be the cards again? That is for you to ponder. Master the cards and make your way through the castle, but from here you walk alone. Apparently, I think this game was supposed to come up before Kingdom Hearts 2. It ended up coming up after Kingdom Hearts 2. The Chain of Memories. Yeah, sorry, I can't do anything without our help. Thanks a lot, Donald. Sure you'll be okay? Of course. You want me to go alone? Fine, I can take care of myself. The hero speaks boldly. Go then, the rest of the castle of Oblivion awaits. Walk the avenues of latent memory, and you shall meet someone dear to you. I still think this is really sketchy. Got a bad feeling about this. Relax, Jiminy. I'm ready for any tricks he's got up his sleeve. How hard can it be to figure out these cards? All I have to do is use one in front of that door over there. I could possibly go wrong. Key of Beginnings. I'll definitely have to tweak the volume. It's the save point. You can prefer to follow actions in the field. Left analog, right analog to move. You don't know how amazing it is to look around with the right stick. R3 to face forward. Swing keyblade S. Jump, roll. Oh, so you can use your keyblade. But not during battles. Nice. Striking objects in the field with your keyblade yield various results. Try striking a barrel. Okay. Blizzard. Marked objects can be lifted and thrown. Press triangle lift. Give me a second to tweak the volume. Okay, that's much better. So, press triangle and what? Holy shit. Touching a heartless on a field starts a battle. But you can strike the Heartless first to gain the upper hand. Alright. Nice. Okay. And that puts you in the battle. Interesting. Okay. Oh, so I'm basically doing it like the good old fashioned way. No. Shit. Goofy, kick his ass. Hey, that's pretty good. Tranquil Darkness card obtained. This is a completely different game than Kingdom Hearts 1. To open doors in the field, press triangle in front of the door. proceed to the next room, you need a map card. Okay, where are my map cards? Map cards are used to synthesize new unexplored rooms. First, select the map card you want to use. Left analog, switch card type. I don't know which is a map type. A room where only a few heartless appear. A room where you can save your progress, no heartless. A room where untold stories unfold. So I'm supposed to click on this one, I think. Oh, never mind. I can save, but I won't do that now. I guess this one. Number you see in the middle of the screen, criterion for opening a door, yada yada, criterion displayed now means the door will open with value of 1 or greater. You need to pick a card that meets this criterion. Alright. Cards have marked values 0 from 9. 0 cards mark 0 are special cards which meet all criteria. Okay. The card without a marked value is a key card. Key cards are only used at special doors. Alright. This is a bit confused. It'll just take a bit of getting used to my stuff. It's a bit confusing. The swirling crystal in front of Sora is called a save point. Stand near it and press triangle to open the save menu. Usual. Alright, get this shit. I don't even know what the hell it is, but I'm getting it. Oh, wait, can I? Yes! Alright, give me a second to check the settings. There we go. For some reason, the left and right was inverted. I can't jump. Oh yeah, circle. I'm returning. And save. Alright, let me just save it. There we go. I don't know what the heck Moogle points are, but I guess that's earning a currency. Triangle. Oh, yeah. I guess it's this. Voila. This is so weird. I definitely see why people are turned off by this. It's not... Oh, goddamn. Alright, you're gonna have the advantage, I'm guessing, since you hit me first. These are shit cards. Not gonna lie. No. Okay. No. Oh my god. Goddamn, this is a pain in the ass. Yeah, I just fucked that up. Come on, Goofy. Help me out here. I am so not used to, Shit. I'm so not used to, Card break. Give me card break. Oh, you little shits. Oh my god! I'm not used to this shit at all. Alright. Sora's voice. It's so weird. Come on. There we go. There we go. Why is it like this? They should have tried to spice it up a bit. And a remake. I mean, at least it's in 3D, unlike before. Level up. HP boost raises Sora's HP. Heart capacity, learn and use sleigh. What the hell is a sleigh? Sliding dash? Huh. Yeah, this seems completely different. Sling a sleigh, fuck it. Sure, I learned sliding dash. Slide towards distance, targets for close range deck, 3 attacks, cards of the same type, total value. Okay. Alright, so, interesting. Ah, oh, fuck. Okay. I don't think I did. No, I did not. Oh my god, you still do this shit. Even though. Okay. Oh, we got it. Nice. Evil darkness. -2. No idea what the fuck I'm doing. So, this is like a compass, I guess? Oh. Let me Let me get through these fights. Oh, I got something. Strong initiative. Times two. I guess you learn these in order, maybe? I don't know. Choose your bonus. Raise my card. Okay, let's just go with that. I don't know. Card points. They do something. Can't I choose world cards, review decks? I can edit the decks. Okay. I can add Blizzard. How the fuck do I add it? Standard. The value is shit, so. What the fuck am I doing? Alright, so. Oh, wait, I increased the card capacity, so it's all good. Oh my god. You gotta make text, but this is definitely different. Friends on a goofy deck one. Okay, yeah, that's another card. Cure. Relax. And I can add this cure to my inventory. There we go. This is gonna take me somewhere. I guess that one's just like a side path. You little shit. Okay, oh my god. Oh, please no. Okay. What's this? A room where heartless weak cards appear. Room untold stories unfold. Minus two, sleep in darkness. Yeah, fuck it, let's see what's up. Oh, wait. Am I supposed to go here? I think I'm supposed to go to the crown area. Yeah, like over there. Fuck. Can I just go back and come back anytime? Yeah, it's constantly open. Okay, so that's good. Alright, so this one just meant higher than a 1. So we're gonna check out what's over here. Let's see what's up before we move on to the other door. I don't know how the progress in this game works. But I'm assuming we'd want to open these doors first. Like, by order. Fighting alone isn't gonna be as easy as I thought. Who dat? More amigos? Ah! Don't pop out of nowhere like that. Hey, it's not our fault. We don't know what's going on. A hyuk? Oh no. A hyuk. Please no. There's fucking Pluto. You know this is all your fault, Pluto. Things keep getting stranger. What's Pluto doing here? There's nothing strange about that. We came to Traverse Town with Pluto, didn't we? Did we? We're all getting amnesia now. Jiminy's got a journal. No, wait. According to my journal, it was before you met Sora that you came to town with Pluto. Well, he's right. We were chasing after Pluto, and that's how we ended up in Castle Oblivion. But aren't we in Traverse Town? Well, it's not really Traverse Town. I think the card created this Traverse Town inside Castle Oblivion. Ah, who cares about all that? It's too confusing. I don't know where we are, but let's just keep moving forward, defeating Heartless. We'll get somewhere. Hey, that's pretty good. Now you better be careful, or it's the Heartless that are going to defeat you. Huh? Senor Leon, or fake Leon, whoever the hell this is. Leon, it's you. What are you doing in Castle Oblivion? Castle Oblivion? What are you talking about? This is Traverse Town. And how do you know my name? Who are you? Oh boy. Exclamation. Never met the likes of you before. Quit playing, Leon. We all fought the Heartless together, you know that. Like I don't know what you're talking about. I don't even know your names. Are we gonna fight, Leon? You don't? Sorry. Can't believe it. How can you... Sorry, you're an idiot. I feel sorry. I feel for you, but you've got the wrong guy. It happens all the time. Don't take it personally, Sora. How do you know his name? You do know his name. Now hold on. Why do I know your name? You think Leon's just kidding around? If he is, it's not funny. Sora's really upset. He's kidding around, Goofy. You and Donald are the ones who... Oh. Bait. You played yourself. I don't get it. Something's wrong with my memory. What's happening here? Now, is that really Leon, or is that, fake Leon? I don't know, Leon. Maybe Aerith was onto something after all. Oh, wait, never mind. It's probably is them. Sufi's here, too. Something about Aerith being onto something. She said she sensed some uncanny... Uncanny kind of power? I don't know if that's what that said. And asked us to look into it. I kind of skimmed through it. Well, this is as uncanny as it gets. Maybe you should take Sora to see Aerith. Beefy, you know my name. Yep, looks like you know mine too. You know him? Oh my god. Nope, total stranger, but I definitely know his name, Jesus. Strange, yes, but convenient. We can skip the introductions. How is it that you can accept a situation so easily? I don't get it. Well, I'm gonna run ahead and fill Aerith and Leon. You give them the grand tour. See you later. Goofy, Pluto, why don't you just stick with Donald and Goofy? I guess it's no use pondering over it. Come on, follow me. But there are heartless wandering around town. Better teach you how to protect yourself in battle with these nifty cards I got from this sketchy dude. Okay, see the numbers printed on your cards? They range from 0 to 9. Higher numbers mean stronger attacks. If you and your enemy both play a card at the same time, the higher card wins. Oh god damn it. Card break. That's what's been happening. See how it works? Playing a card higher than your opponent and breaking through their defense is called card break. Playing a lower card results in your attack being deflected. Even powerful cards can be deflected if the enemy's card is higher. Whoever is on the losing side of a break is left wide open to attacks. Don't let that person be you. So you want to start off with the high ones. Cards of zero is their value or special. No matter what card the enemy plays, you can break it with a zero card. But if you played a zero card too soon, the enemy can break it with any card they play. In other words, it's the most powerful card if it comes last, and useless if it comes first. Try to make the most of it. Okay. Card values also affect the cost of assembling a deck. Keep that in mind. Now it's time to teach you how to stock cards. You don't have to use battle cards one at a time. You can also assemble three cards and use them all at once. This is called stocking cards. Stocking cards and using them in threes is much stronger than using the cards individually. Go on, give it a try. Stock any three cards in your deck. Good. There we go. Sliding dash. That's how we do that. The sum of your three stock cards becomes the value you play. Value is usually high and hard to break, and the combo attack deals a lot of damage. Don't hold back. Show me what you got. There we go. Combo attacks are the only benefit of stocking cards. Choose your cards carefully, and you can unleash special abilities called slays. Slays come in all varieties, and each has its own unique card combination. You should try it out once you've collected more cards, or a slay or two, like I just did. But keep one thing in mind. Every time you use stock cards, you lose the first card you picked, so you can't reload it. The lost card won't return until the end of the battle. That's a pain in the ass. Relying only on slays will cause your cards to run out. That means trouble. I think you've got the hang of it, Sora. Yeah, more or less. I'll pick up the rest when I fight some real battles. Here, found this lying around. You take it. Remember what I told you and make good use of it. Simba. Key of Guidance. Okay. I mean, it's different, but it is intriguing, I guess. It's a different type of Kingdom Hearts. spices things up. And now this door is gone and we can continue forward. But yeah, that's it for this episode, everyone. I hope you enjoyed it and thanks for watching. In the next episode, we'll continue exploring Traverse Town and hopefully get a better hang of how this combat works. So yeah, see you next.